together as high as you can. You guys ready? One, two, three.
With all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, with all my strength, with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, with all my strength. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. Da 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 da
Detectives, tiptoe, look high, look low, reach out, don't shout,
look out and find, we search for the clues, God gives us the truth, because he loves me, because he loves you.
Detectives, tiptoe, look high, look low, reach out, don't shout,
look out and find, we search for the clues, God gives us the truth, because he loves me, because he loves you.
Detectives, tiptoe, look high, look low, reach out, don't shout,
look out and find, we search for the clues, God gives us the truth, because he loves me, because he loves you. We search for the clues, God gives us the truth, because he loves me, because he loves you.
Some of you are busy waking up like this. Mommy, I want to sleep. I just woke up. Some people are still waking up. Wake up. I know it's either 7:30 on your side or 8 a.m. in the morning and you are still sleeping, whether you are in Pretoria sleeping, in Cape Town sleeping, or anywhere else in Africa, maybe in Zimbabwe sleeping, if you are anywhere else, or maybe in Gauteng you are busy sleeping. Okay. Anywhere you are in South Africa or outside of South Africa watching us, I want to say good morning. It's an amazing Sunday. It's an amazing Sunday. And I'm wearing my nice pink. Can you kids see my pink top? Is it nice? I'm wearing it because guess what? Last week, it was... What was it? Last week, Sunday was It was Valentine's Day last Sunday. So I want to ask all the boys, can all the boys jump twice? If you are a boy watching this, can you jump twice? Okay. And all the girls that are watching this, can you get on your feet and jump three times? Let's do it. One, two, and three. Okay, for the girls, one more time. I want you to jump three times. Are you ready, girls? One, two, and three. Well done, girls. Well done, boys. So, boys, who was your Valentine? Did you have any Valentine? No? No! No one wanted to be a Valentine. Oh, I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. Okay, boys, I'm so sorry. Let me check the girls on this side who jumped three times. Girls, can you jump three times one more time? Let's do it together. Are you ready? One, three. Two, three, three. Three, 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 three. Okay, so girls, did you have any Valentine? Did you have any Valentine, girls? I know what the girls are saying. Daddy was my Valentine, or Grandpa was my Valentine. Well done, girls. I'm glad you had a Valentine. My Valentine was my wife, Lucy. And I need to tell you this is a secret, but there's a small surprise for her at home, and she doesn't even know about it. That's why she's not here watching this video. So we'll send you pictures of her reaction, what she says. Maybe we'll show it, we'll put it on social media, on our Kids Life page, maybe. But I want you guys, if you guys have got any Valentine or any fun thing that happened on Valentine with mommy, with daddy, or with grandpa, with anyone in the family, please, kids, tell mommy and daddy or any adult that is with you, ask them to send it to us. We want to see you wearing your red outfit. Everybody was wearing red. Can you guys see red right there? There you go. Okay, everybody was wearing red. Send us a picture of you on your Valentine's Day and what you were dressed up as. We want to put it on our social media because we think love is a beautiful feeling. And the one who created love was God. God was the first one to create love. And God says that the Father, who's God, loves the Son, who's Jesus Christ, and the Son loves the Father, who is God, and they love each other, and then the Holy Spirit is also in there, and they are so perfect that the three of them love each other like this, like brother and father and son, and they just love each other. So God created us out of that love that He has for us. And that's why I think Valentine's Day is an amazing day to remember to love each other. Wow, that's amazing. All right. Okay, so getting into today's story, I want to say if you are ready to listen to today's story, I want you to tap on your tummy three times like me. I want you to put your tummy outside like me, like this. Yoo-hoo, can you see my tummy? I want you to get your hands ready and go one, two, three. Okay, are you kids ready? Okay, pop your tummy out. First thing we do, we pop our tummy out like this. Pew! Do you guys see it? And I walk. Do you guys see it? And my tummy is big because my wife and myself, we are pregnant. That's why I've got such a big tummy. So let's pretend we are all pregnant. So pop your tummy out like this. Ooh. And then I put some air in my tummy. Ooh, do you see it now? Okay. And then we're going to clap three times. One, two, three. One more time. One, two, three. Faster. One, two, three. Faster. One, two, three. Faster. One, two, three. Yeah, now I know everybody is awake and ready for the story. I am so excited. But how about everybody close their eyes and then we can pray. And before we pray, let me tell you why we pray. We pray because we want to talk to God. We want to talk to Jesus. Yes. Well done to you. We pray because we want to talk to Jesus, because guess what? Nothing that I say here, nothing that I say is something that we can do with our own strength. I can't do this in my own strength. Yes, I am strong, and I know some of you here are so strong, but we can't do this in our own strength. We need Jesus to come and help us in His strength. So I'm telling you this message, but I need Jesus to come and help me tell you this message. In the same way, you guys can't hear this message with your own ears like this. You guys can't. Somebody says that I got big ears. I don't have big ears. No, I don't have big ears. All right, so some of you can't do this. You can't listen to this message with your ears. You need to listen it with your heart. And the one person that helps your heart receive this message is Jesus. And that's why we are praying to Jesus. So I need you guys to stop doing everything that you're doing. And I want everybody to just freeze. Everybody's frozen? Are you sure you are frozen in your house? Okay, tell your mommy to freeze as well. She needs to freeze. Everybody has to freeze. Okay, so now let's pray. And I want you to repeat after me. Kids, dear God, thank you so much for today. Please, God, I know that I am not good, but I know that you are good. So help me be good just like you. And help me, help my heart hear this message. In Jesus' name, amen. That was such a simple prayer, and I'm proud of you guys for repeating this prayer. And guess what? I'm praying with you because I want you guys to keep on praying on your own. It's so simple. It's so easy to talk to your daddy who is in heaven. And the Holy Spirit, once you accept Jesus, comes and lives inside of you, so you are not alone. The Holy Spirit is with you. And you can talk to Jesus anytime you want. So let me do this. I'm going to give you 10 seconds. Okay. Kids, I know you guys are young, and some of you are like hungry. I need to eat breakfast. Some of you are eating snacks here. Some of you are running around the house. Yay! Some of you are even crying while you're watching this video. Oh, mommy. Ah, ah. And that's all good. It's for you. It's normal to cry. But I want you guys to freeze for a second. Everybody freeze. Shh. Everybody freeze. So you guys heard me pray. How about you take the time to pray to God and tell him anything that you want? Because this year, we are talking about go. Remember I said that last week? We're talking about go. And we cannot go if we don't know how to talk to God and pray before we go. Okay, so I want you guys, very important, to learn to pray before you go. So how about I pause for 10 seconds? And I want the mommies to stop moving in the house and making breakfast. I want the daddies to stop reading the newspapers and playing on their phones. And I want everybody, boys and girls that are watching me, I want you to tell mommy, mommy, freeze. If you're with your granny or your grandpa, tell granny, freeze. Grandpa, freeze. Everybody, freeze. So that they can hear you pray, because God wants to hear you pray. So 10 seconds, only 10 seconds, and I'm going to be counting so that you can pray to Jesus. Okay. I am counting to three, and then you can get started and tell Jesus anything that you want in 10 seconds. Okay, so one, two, and three, and everybody freeze, and you pray. Mm-hmm. Jesus, I hope you're hearing this beautiful prayer from these children. It's so honest and beautiful. Did you pray for your daddy and your mommy? Did you pray for your friends at school? Well done. Come on, parents. Everybody in the house, give them one. Give them one. Give them one big clap. Well done. I'm loving it. And guys, we are going to carry on with our story. Last week, we started our series to go. Can everybody go like me and lift up their knees like me like this? Lift up your knees. I hope you can see my knees. Lift up your knees. Go, 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 go. Oops. I think my back is locked. I need to turn around like this so that I can see you guys. My back is hurting. Owie. Owie. Oh, feels much better. This poor back of mine. I feel like I'm a grandpa and I'm getting old. Oh. Anyways, let's carry on. So we've been talking about to go. Okay. And we said the last thing Jesus said to the disciples was to go, go, go. And we talk about sheep and we talk about shepherd. We had a great shepherd who came here. And we said, there's a lot of people who are going to say, listen to me. But we can't listen to them. The only person we'll listen to is Jesus, because he's the good shepherd. Can Jesus is the good shepherd. Can you guys repeat this after me? One, two, three. Jesus is the good shepherd. Okay, get your hands like this. Let's go. Jesus is the good shepherd. Okay, one more time. Come on, kids, you can say it louder. Jesus is the good shepherd. Well done, I'm so proud of you. Now you guys remember that story, and the Bible says, my sheep, we are sheep. And we says, Jesus is a shepherd who looks after sheep. My sheep hear my voice and they follow me. Can we try and say this one more time? My sheep hear my voice and they follow me. Come on, one more time, let's do it together. My sheep, so my sheep hear my voice and they follow me. That's what Jesus says. So we need to hear his voice and follow him. And the only way to hear God's voice, it's hot in here. Okay. The only way to hear God's voice is through the Bible. So as we read the Bible and ask our parents to read the Bible to us, guess what? We learn to listen and follow our shepherd. Who's he? Jesus. Well done. And today we're going to talk about a different story in the Bible. And I know I've been talking for long, but I hope you guys are getting this. Okay, we are going to talk about a different story, and it's in a different book in the Bible. Are you guys ready? Okay, so I'm going to give you 5 seconds to go grab your Bibles and bring it. Okay, run and get your Bibles. I know you guys can't read, but run and find a Bible and bring it. One, two, three, go! One, two, get your Bible. Three, four, five, and I hope you have your Bible. If you don't have your Bible, I'm going to keep on talking. But come, bring your Bible. Kiddos, go grab your Bibles. Okay, we're going to be checking a story in Luke 15, 1 to 7. Okay, so this is what it talks about. Okay, Luke 15, chapter 15, verse 1 to 7. Okay, because I want you guys to go read it. I want your parents to read you the story after this story. Because I can make mistakes, but the Bible never, ever, 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 ever make mistakes. So this is what it says. It says, we talked about sheep. You guys remember that? Okay, so I've got a sheep here. Let's play a quick game before I tell you more about that story. So I want you to ask your mommy to come in the room. Whoever is with your mommy, your granny, or your grandpa, or your uncle, or your auntie, any adult that is with you, I want you to ask them to come. But if your mommy's in the house, say, mommy, come watch. Okay, I'm going to wait for mommies to come. Mommies, come. Or if you're watching this from church, ask your volunteers who's helping you to come so they can join you. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. I am going to do a sheepy competition with your mommy or your teacher or your daddy or your granny who's at home with you. And you get to decide who's the best sheep. So at three, I want you guys to count to three with me. And then I'm going to make a sheepy voice. And then your mommy or your teacher or your granny need to make a sheepy voice. Okay, so one, two, three. Okay, that's my sheepy voice. Your turn, mommies. You go. Come on, mommies. Don't be shy. Come on, do it louder. Come on, mommies. Kids, can you support your mommies and your grannies and your teachers to make a sheepy voice? One, two, three, go. Which voice do you think is better? Mine or your mommy's? Let's try one more time. I'm going to do mine and mommy. You need to do yours, or granny or teacher. You need to do yours. Okay. I'm going to do mine. That's my sheepy voice. Now, granny or mommy or teacher, your turn. You go. Let's see. One, two, three, go. No, it's not good enough. Who's the winner? Come on, guys. I know I am the winner. My voice is the best. And so we're going to carry on with the story of the sheep, and we are the sheep in this story. And so Jesus says this. He says, at one stage, the people of Israel came and they saw Jesus teaching a story and the Bible to a lot of bad people. So you guys go to school, there are some really bad kids and there are some good kids. So Jesus came and he shared his story with all the bad kids. All the bad kids, not so good. And the people who are the good people came and said, Jesus, why are you sharing your story with the bad kids and not the good kids? Why them? And so Jesus said, I'll tell you a story. Imagine that you have 100 sheep. That's a lot of sheep. You have 100 sheep. And in the 100 sheep that you have, one sheep goes away. Then you have to find that one sheep. He says the good shepherd will leave all the 99 sheep that he's got to go find, to go. So he's going to have to go find the one sheep that's gone away. And so, and the teacher, the people listening to Jesus said, what does that even mean? How do I understand this? And Jesus said to them, this is what it means. Jesus said, I didn't come for the good kid. I came to go and find all the bad kids that have left all the other sheep. So he says, my purpose is to go and find all the sheep that are lost. Now, some of us are lost because we don't even know about the Bible. Some of our friends at school are lost. Some of our parents are even lost. And so Jesus says, I want to go and find them and bring them back so they can be with all the other sheep. And so, but Jesus also wants, before as he goes, he wants to go with some of you. So he says, why don't you come with me so we can go together and finding all the other lost sheep. What do you guys say? That sounds cool, right? Jesus is such a cool guy because he wants to include everyone. And I think that's an amazing story. So, are you a sheep? Yes, you are a sheep. And I am a sheep. And there are many other sheep that are not with you that have gotten lost. And Jesus wants to use you, wants to work with you, not to use you. He wants to work with you to go help find the other sheep. So, kids, this is the story for today. Because as we go, it's important for us to pray and talk to Jesus so he can go and guide us in finding all the other lost sheep. What do you say? Would you like to find some lost sheep? So here's a game to remember this story that I want to give all the parents. I want you to get your kids' toys and hide them all over the house. Okay, and get the kids to go find all of these lost toys. And when they find these lost toys, I want you to tell them that's what Jesus does. He goes and finds everything that lost to bring it back where it's supposed to be. And that's what he wants us to do. He wants us to go to school. School is starting soon. And to go tell our friends about God, about Jesus, so they can come back and to be friends with Jesus. That's it. That's the story today. I love spending time with you kids. I will see you guys next week. For now, ciao. Bye.